My name is Bart Stein. I work for Lantor and I'm here to present our new material, the Skincore. You can have material samples here in the front. I have prepared a live infusion for you. This will be an infusion of our Skincore using only azoric as a flow medium and two layers of biaxial glassfibre. First, I will tell you a bit more about Skincore, what it does and why you should use it. Especially in constructions like boats and houses where you have exposure to water, to weather, and composite laminate will undergo a few effects. These effects include osmosis, wear, and resin shrinkage, ultraviolet degradation. These are all detrimental to the look and feel of the construction, but also to the safety of the composite construction. So you need to shield the structure to prevent these effects from happening, because if you don't, your construction will be starting to blister, the resin will start to degrade, and you can have structural failure in the event of damage. Now, the industry already has two solutions to prevent all this. One is a barrier coat and one is a skin coat. And these are two independent layers that have to be specially applied. The skin barrier coat usually in spray, which has to dry, and then the skin coat, which is usually hand laminated and also has to set. These are time consuming processes, and yeah, they also add a lot to the cost of the composite construction. But you cannot deny the effect that if you apply these layers, your construction is protected. Now, on here on the screen, you have a very good result using a Lantor Finishmat and a Lantor infusion core and some glass fiber in the front. What we did is stitch that together into one layer that can be applied directly to the gel coat in any construction and one shot infused with the rest of the construction, giving the effect of a barrier coat and a skin coat without the time consuming processes of applying them. Now, these layers can be used in infusion, in RTM, and it can also be applied to any shape. It will stretch, it will conform, you don't have to cut much, you won't get any blank spots in the glass fiber. And of course, the most important thing for our customer is how does the end result look. Now, we did a measurement comparing several layups without a skin coat, with a skin coat, and with our skin crawl. And the result is that the blue line is without any skin coat. You get a lot of disturbance in the range of 1 to 10 millimeters. And these are the disturbances that are caused by fiber print through and the print through of the core material. And you can see the red line is the skin coat. It already blocks a lot of these visual effects, but the skin core goes even further, smoothing out and making sure that even after the thermal cycle, after resin shrinkage, your gel coat is still smooth without any print. And with that, it is time to start the infusion. So I'm using a standard polyester DCPD resin, nothing special there. It's going to be about 200 millipascals, and the total resin consumption here will be about 1.2, 1.4 kilograms of resin, which has to be equally distributed. Please notice that I'm only using 0.8 vacuum, but you will see there will be no air bubbles in the skin core, creating a very closed sheet of resin to protect and create that barrier coat skin coat effect.